Hey guys, so it is Friday and just doing a hop, skip and a jump across the highway so that I can get to the location of my staycation. And I'm excited to be away from home for two nights, even though it's like I could probably shout the witch's name and be like, hey, nyaje ebo nak ebo kuna nguo nimeacha zikiranga hapo nje ebo nitole. I feel like I could so easily do that. Anyway, let me focus on driving now.
I just got to my room at the Radisson and yeah, it's beautiful. We're on the 8th floor and the view is so spectacular. So beautiful. This is my room and let me just be honest. This place is literally 5 minutes away from my house. But once I've checked in, I feel like I'm far away on a holiday. It's cool. I'm gonna come chill in that a little bit later. And then business on that a little bit later. And look at this closet. Na kuna kapasi hapa, naweza piga piga nguo pasi. Yes.
Humidor. This is Mary. She's shy. Again about the witch doctor.
Witch doctor.
Yeah.
It has sage.
Sage.
Basil.
Basil.
It has passion palm.
Ah, that's mine. Uh-huh. Yeah.
It has lime, fresh lime juice.
Yeah.
And gin.
Witch that's doctor. The witch doctor. Oh. I love passion.
Very happy actually.
Yes. Okay, let's make a toast, guys. Hey! So it's time for dinner, and I went to the buffet with Anita, Sarah. Hi. Woo! I scream. You scream. We scream together. We're going back to the bar. How about you? That's so cool. I need to have the dopest stuff. Yes.
Stop the witch doctor for 1 second.
Oi.
Because I'm leaving.
Anita is interrupting my documentation.
Look,
of this witchcraft being made.
What I'm doing is also witchcraft.
Hey, what do Emmanuel and you have?
That's a mimi niko na mainse.
This camera view makes everyone look good. Jesus Christ. It's the lighting. Once you get the lighting right, then you're good.
See?
full of witchcraft. Woo, yes. See you. Have fun tonight. At any competition, gani yo, ulikuwa top 6?
The World Class DIG competition for bartenders, 2018. I came the top 6 in Zimbabwe.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I've been doing the competition for the last 4 years.
Yeah.
But this year is the one I managed to get to the top 6.
Damn.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you very
much.
Hey
guys, I am back in my room. I think it's a little after midnight. We were sitting at the bar after dinner, just beating stories. But yeah, I just go back to the room. It's so beautiful. But my favorite part is that I opened the curtains because I want to sleep with this view. But look at that. Look at that. What is that? Focus. Look at the night sky. Look at that. It's so beautiful. I am running a bath. Can you see the bubbles? All those people who have been asking me, how do I get to travel so much? It's because I wash myself. I run my own baths and I wash myself. Some of them are sponsored like this, like an establishment will get in touch and say that they would like to host me. But others, I pay for my own tickets. Okay, no shade to anybody. Do your thing. Do what you gotta do. Focus. Can you focus on me? Can you focus on? Woo! Yes! Oh, yes! There we go! Baby, can you focus on me? Huku niko peke yangu. Huh? I'm not here with a sponsor. The sponsor is the hotel. Come on! I know I'm just laughing and like, I'm not trying to throw shade at anybody. I have to be up by 6:30. It is now 1 in the morning. I don't know how to say this name. Angie Dussault. How do you do what you do? How do you afford to travel so much? What keeps you going? So everything that I do, first of all, there's a lot. So let's start from the very beginning. I'm a singer. A lot of people imagine that singing means having a song on radio or on TV with a music video. I'm still figuring that out, but I still sing and I still sing on commercial projects. This year I happened to work on a really huge project, which was an animated film, and I voiced the African character. I don't know if it's come out, but if it has, I'll put the poster here now. If it hasn't, in another video. I like doing stuff like that. That doesn't necessarily put me in the limelight, but it means I can still sing. I still get to sing, so that's fun. So that's singing. Acting, I act as well. So this year I was in 2 films that came out this year. So Disconnect, the one by Tosh Kitonga, and Rafiki. Although Rafiki was a small role, I was an actress in that, but I was also the music supervisor in that film. So that just means all the music that you heard in the film, I sort of curated it. And I'm an improv comedian, so my friends and I, BYSS, we do a show every 2 months where we are on stage without a script and we just crack up and ujinga mingi too on stage, and people come and laugh at us or laugh with us, whatever that means. Singer, actress, radio presenter, improv comedian, content creator on social media, so my Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. I'm also a radio presenter and I have a show on Homeboys Radio called Afro Central. I've also done writing gigs over the last couple of years. Just here and there, I've written for MTV, I've written for Yummy Magazine, I used to write for Drum Magazine way back when. What else? I think that's pretty much it. In 2017, I did have a day job. It was a really, really good job. It was working at a creative agency. I thought it was my dream job, but it turned out to not be what I expected, and I felt like my soul was getting crushed. So after 8 months, I couldn't stay there any longer. Everybody who was there was absolutely amazing. My boss was amazing. It was a company that was founded in Nigeria, and then they opened an office here. My bosses in Nigeria were amazing.
but I just didn't feel like my heart and soul were in it. So I had to make a really, really difficult decision to leave a really, really good job with a great salary, but it wasn't for me. And I felt lighter since I left. I got to save some money from that. So 2018, I just decided to travel and say yes to any opportunity to travel. It's not that I'm rolling in the monies, but also I've been working. I realized I've been working hard. Oh, another thing I do also is MC. So I MC events, corporate events or entertainment events. I host those as well. And just things here and there, like entertainment. I'll sing at events as well once in a while. So there's a lot that I do, and I enjoy everything that I do, and I'm grateful to God for granting me the opportunity to do what I love and make money from it. Do you know how much of a privilege that is? Like, every single day I am so thankful. I am so grateful that I get to live my life in this way. It's hard work, trust me. But it's work that I enjoy. In fact, there's even a new project I'm going to be starting that I can't wait to share with you guys. So it's like constant grind and hustle. If you see me posting on my stories at 3 in the morning that I'm working, trust me, I'm probably editing, shooting, doing a proposal, something. But I enjoy it. So even when I'm traveling, if I'm documenting it, that's work. I really want to take a trip where I can just unplug. Like even here, I should really just be taking a break and enjoying myself. But no, I've decided to shoot in this hotel. So nice, I should be sleeping. But no. Where do you buy earrings? You're so full of positive energy. Do you like have low days? These are from Guo Studio. Ooh, battery aziz, battery aziz, battery aziz. Let me replace the battery. Shall we proceed to give you what you need? I buy my earrings from various places, Kipato and branded. These are from Guo Studio. They're beautiful. Today I'm beaded, not brassy. This is from Walove by Design. She makes some really amazing neck pieces, chokers. Rings from Masai Market, Kipato and branded. I basically just get stuff from all over, but there are so many people that I get jewelry from. Yes, I do have my low days. There was once somebody said something to me, a close friend. She was like, hey, Patricia, there's some days, yani, anybody around you who was following you on social media knew you were having a bad day. Baka people will just stay away. Made me super conscious about the kind of energy that I want people to leave my spaces with. Fiona, what would you tell your 16 to 21-year-old self? What have you learned that you wish you knew? I would say to my younger self that you are exactly who you need to be. You don't need to adjust yourself for anybody to like you. You don't need to tweak anything. Yes, there's room to grow, but growth is growing you, expanding yourself, like becoming more of yourself, not changing yourself into someone else. Just know that there's nothing about you that is extra, too much, unlovable, needs to fix this, or thinks like this and just needs to tweak this so that people can love, or, you know, there's nothing that you need to do to make yourself palatable to anybody. Your people will find you and you will find them. You, as you are just great. Work on growing yourself. Don't work on changing. You dig? All right, next question. What's your biggest insecurity? My biggest insecurity is that I'm just not good enough at anything that I do. Oh, I really struggle with being happy or content with anything that I do. Even when I put out stuff, I usually have to give myself a pep talk and say, you know what, just do it and then learn from this and grow. But I usually really struggle with anything that I create, anything that I do, anything that I create, anything that's a project that I'm a part of. Even as soon as I start doubting it instantly. How much does radio pay? Is it a sustainable career? I work 2 hours in a week, so it's not a job that I would be able to live off of. It's a labor of love. I don't know anybody else's salary, so I can't tell you if it's sustainable. But if you're looking to get into radio, I would say, and this is something that I've been asked by a few people, right now with our digital space, the thing with radio is that the day's hours are covered. So if you're saying you want a show of your own, it's either you're taking somebody's job because you have to take those hours that they host, or you're filling a space that's blank. You have to do your research on all the stations, figure out which station has a blank space that they could fill and show them an idea that they can't refuse, or start a podcast, create your own following, create your own dope content, and then take that to the station and say, hey, I've been doing this for however amount of time. This is my listenership. This is how popular I am. I would like a spot on your station. Can we do this? But right now with radio, you have to just consider that radio hours are slots. What slot are you coming in to fill? Or whose spot are you coming to take? It's only 24 hours in a day. A station can't add another 2 hours to make it 26. So for instance, when I joined HPR, they wanted me to do the news, and I said, I really didn't want to do the news, but I said, you know what? I'll do the news if you give me 2 hours, a show where I can play this kind of music. And they were like, you know what? We actually have a slot. We had a show called Afro Central from before. We don't have that show anymore, but if you're willing to fill that, you can take that slot. Cool Geek, what's your favorite 10 songs in your playlist? Wow. Can I say artists? Because I don't know if I can just say 10 songs, because I don't listen to music like that. I don't listen to individual songs. I listen to like entire albums all at once. So I would say right now, Wanja Uhuru, who just launched her album, is so dope. I love Dempsey. It's a Kenyan. I love Mumbi Kasumba, Ignited. That's a dope song. I love Lisa Noah. Yeah. The new album by The Nest Collective. I love Mayonde's music. Mayonde is always dope. Silas Miami. I really enjoy a dude called Dave Ndegwa. He's so dope. I love Njoki Karu. Those are off the top of my mind. But, ooh, Kemunto has a song called Maybe. Damn, that's a jam. Woo! Hallelujah. Kemunto. Of course, Sauti Sol. You got it all going on with your body. Come on. Did TPF help you in any way in terms of your career? I think TPF definitely gave me visibility. More people know my face. More people knew my name. But that didn't necessarily translate into jobs being handed to me. I still had to audition for stuff. I still had to come and present myself and say, yeah, I can do that. It helped with people knowing who I am. Remembering, oh, you can sing. I saw you on that show. But it didn't guarantee me work. And exposure does not pay your bills. So exposure just means people see you and they're like, when you let them? Project fame. It was definitely a great experience. And you know what? It gives you credibility in that I was a finalist. So I made it right to the end. But it didn't necessarily translate into work. I still had to tough out work. I still had to grind and hustle. Odwal G, if you didn't do what you do now, what do you think you'd be doing? I don't know. Maybe I'd be a teacher, because I'm such a kimbelembele. I'm a know-it-all. I'm always like, actually, you know, if you... What keeps you pushing even on the worst of days? To be honest, experience has taught me that even the worst days pass. So I know that it's just for a moment. It's not a lasting situation. So there's days where I'm just like, hey, this can't be worth it. Sometimes it's like, it's a really low day. But because I've gotten through them before, it gets better when I remember, okay, the last time I felt like this, I got past it. And then my friends, I have one or two friends that I can tell. Like on the days when I feel like talking to no one, I can actually just say, yo, I'm just, it's been difficult. And I'm struggling. I'm also just thinking about my family, man. My family are dope. My family are so amazing. And they're so funny. And they're just so... They're weird people just like I am. And I think about how lucky and blessed I am to have them. Sonny Love, 1215. Caesars alienda wapi na alipata nini form 4? I think of Caesars and I think it's just such a sad story, man. That guy was so dope. To just disappear like that, I think about his family and how they must feel. Wherever he is, I hope he's okay. Lily, 92T. How did you deal with the disappointment of not winning TPF? Honestly, I wasn't disappointed. My goal had just been to get to the finals. Let me put it this way. I really didn't want to do TPF, but my friends convinced me. My friend Renee made sure... She came with me to the audition. She was like, I'm auditioning with you whether you want to or not. So... I didn't expect to get through round one, I did. I didn't expect to get through round two, I did. By the time we were getting into the house, it was like round four or five. There'd been questionnaires, there'd been so many things to get to that point. So when I got into the house, I was just thinking to myself, okay, I hope I don't get eliminated and then have to watch this from home. God just let me get to the final day. I don't have to win, let me just get to the final day. That was my goal, and I achieved it, so I wasn't disappointed. And to be honest, looking back at previous musical competitions over the years, whether it's Idols in the UK, X Factor, the winners usually have so much pressure on their backs that I was just like, I'm okay to be fourth, third, I'm okay. Because it just means I was a finalist, but I didn't win, so I didn't have the pressure to be a winner and to be the greatest and to have the best album and whatever. So there was no disappointment there. What are some of your biggest regrets in life? Malia 247. I don't know if I consider anything in my life a regret. I don't think I have any major regrets in life. Everything happened for a reason. Every dude I've dated for a reason. I've learned lessons from them. Yeah, a couple of them were just useless. But otherwise, no regrets. Amavuru. On the reels though, can me and my fam, we're three, get free BYSS tickets? As BYSS cast, we are not allocated an unlimited number of tickets. We each have one or two tickets to give away. And those I give to somebody I'd like to see the show, a potential sponsor for content, a friend, a family member who can't afford to come through. Yeah, sorry. But thank you for wanting to come for the show. I wish I could do more, but it's been almost 5 years. Trust me, Jason Runo does not give us unlimited tickets. We are his employees. Amavuru again. Do you remember when you used to live in Langata and you, me and my dad were besties? I have never lived in Langata in my life. Chantel Shekormed. Are you single? And two, are you bi? Yes, I'm single. No, I'm not bi. Shah Shiko asks, how do you edit your videos? I use Final Cut Pro 10. Sasa tunaoga. So before I take off my makeup, because I'm about to, I can answer a few more questions. Shashiko, how are you able to travel so much? So 2018 was my yes to travel year. So basically what I committed to was if there was an opportunity to travel, I would say yes. And I would make it happen. So I had some savings, so that helped. It was a bit of a careless space I was in. I don't know if I should say that, but I was just like, what if this is the year I die? All these things that I wanted to do, all the travel that I want, da, da, da. Meanwhile, I'm just here saving for what, a house? And then what? What if I get the house? And then what? What about all the travel that I want to do and stuff while I'm still young, while I'm still childless, before I get married, before I have a family? I should take advantage of this time now. So the kind of work that I do, creating content on social media, really helps as well. For instance, like when I booked my ticket, as soon as I paid for my ticket to go to Paris for Afropunk and On the Run, I think 2 days later I got a gig that sort of paid me the same amount that my ticket cost. So I also pray a lot, because I prayed a lot. Forgot to come through. Icharop, how do you maintain your sanity and your boundaries while being hyper visible? That is such a great question. I try to just reveal as much as I'm comfortable with. So there's certain things that I won't really talk about, like relationships, you know, the people that I'm seeing. I won't invade their privacy and share their stuff unless they're comfortable with it. I just try not to think of myself as a hyper visible person. I kind of ignore. I don't know if that's the best strategy, but I try not to think of myself as a hyper visible person. I try to think of myself as just a normal, regular human being. I don't feel embarrassed doing things like getting on a boda boda or a bus or a matatu. And also if I'm driving or in an Uber or whatever, if somebody says, when do you have a knee? I'm just like, yes. And then we move on. Like, I don't act as though I'm hyper visible. I love that I have friends and family who still treat me like they did before any of this happened. So that just reminds me that I'm just Wangeshi. That's what my family calls me. They call me Wang or Wangeshi or Shrek or all these things. So I'm so glad that I have people who were in my life before that. maintaining my sanity and my boundaries. This year I've done a couple of interviews that I chose to share. I was like, you know what, I might as well just share a little bit more if this is what people are curious about. But I don't know, it's like they picked such a small part of my life and made that a big deal that I don't know if I'm gonna do interviews like that again. So I just try not to think too much about it. If you think about it, then it becomes a thing when it really isn't. I'm just a regular human being who people recognize because of the stuff that I do, but I'm not hearty special because of that. I'm just still hustling and living, trying to live my best life. Kanisi Paris, I hope I said your name right, you're asking, what was the best part of OTR 2 on the run 2? That's Beyonce and Jay-Z. In Paris and Nice, which city had the best crowd? Whoa. Wow. Both crowds were pretty dope. Paris was definitely bigger. I think about 80,000 people or 100,000 people. It was huge. Huge. We have not seen so many people in a stadium to watch musical acts. I was flabbergasted. My flubber was well and truly gusted, in the wise words of my friend Victor. The best part of OTR2 was just taking it in. Like, there are moments when I was still and just watching the two of them, the songs that they performed together, those were nice to see, like just how they were looking at each other and vibing with each other and dancing. Well, Beyonce was doing the dancing with him. I also liked the times when Beyonce would come this close to me. It was so surreal. I was just like, what? She's right here. Of course it was confusing because I was like, all these years I've been loving Beyonce and being a fan, and then she's right here and I'm like, Beyonce, ni mimi, hello, ni mimi, Patricia. And then it's like, oh shit, she has no idea I even exist. But there I am, feeling like, why don't you recognize me? That was spooky. I felt like, I was like, now I understand stalking. I don't know if I've answered your question. Seeing them perform songs together, those were dope. Also, I think I'm getting really sleepy. How old were you when you started doing radio? That's Kami Mudoka. I started doing radio in 2010, so 24. That's when 1FM went live and I started doing radio as a news anchor. I only started presenting a show in 2014 at HBR. Big deal, KE. Are you taken? I have been taken for granted. I have been taken for dinner. I am taken to church by my mother. Taken. I'm kidding. I know what you mean. I'm single. I'm not taken by anybody. No. What motivates you? I want, when I'm gone, for people to say, hey, this one good thing, at least, this one good thing is because of Patricia. This one thing that's helped us is because of Patricia. Or this is the impact I had in somebody's life. I know that sounds so selfish. I know. But I just feel like I want for people to be able to say, this woman had a good impact in my life in this small way, and I appreciate it. That's it. I don't want any grand legacies or whatever. That would be great, but really just, I want to be able to be in people's memories. She added a light to my day. She made me laugh one day. She did something or said something that lifted me a little bit. That's it. Last question. Will you ever do an album? Nimefanya album mingi sana. Ukiingia Facebook yangu, utapata ma albums imejaa kibao. I'm sorry, that was really bad. Bad joke. Will I ever do an album? I hope so. Yes, that's one of my intentions. I really want to. Bye! Let me just tell you guys, the view that I'm going to fall asleep to is so wonderful. I'm actually watching planes landing at JKIA. Dreaming deep in peaceful sleep while I stay awake and weep, little girl.